Good morning, friends. After the discussing the number of topics related to C, introduction to C, why we need C, there are different kind of the looping construct, conditional statement. Now we are moving one problem. The problem is, in a class we have 100 students. Objective is to store the roll number of these 100 students and print the value of these students. What you will do? Want to store the roll number of 100 students. What you will do? You will just simply take integer A1 or you can say R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, ... R100. That means you will declare 100 different variables to store the roll number of 100 students. It will be easy for 100. But can we move 100 to 1000? Then it will be very tedious and complex task to score the roll number of 1000 students. How will you do? Integer A1, A2, ... A, 1000. It will be very difficult to remember the name of the variables. And where you store, printf enter the value and scanf %d ... 1000 times you will write the format string %d and then you will store %a1, a2 and ... a1000. And from keyboard you will enter 1000 values and these different values will be stored in these variables. To overcome this problem, to reduce the complexity for such kind of the problem, friends, we will introduce the concept of array. The concept of array. What does it mean? What do you mean by array? Array is nothing. It is one secondary data type. In previous sections, we have discussed the data type, primary data type and secondary data type, or you can say derived data type. Primary data type, integer, character, float, double or number of the sum data type. Secondary data types are the data type that are derived from the primary. The first is array. Today we will discuss the array structure, union, pointer. These are some secondary data type, or you can say derived data type. Now question arises, what meaning of array? Array is nothing. Array is one secondary data type and it is a collection of homogeneous data type. Homogeneous, what is the meaning of the homogeneous data type? In previous problem we have discussed, you want to store the roll number of 1000 students. If you want to store the percentage of 1000 students, if you want to store the name of 100 students, when we talk about the name, that means data type is character array, collection of character. When we talk about the percentage, that means we are talking some float value. When we say roll number, that means we are talking some integer value. That means if we talk array means collection of character or collection of float or collection of integer, that means homogeneous. How it will be declared? Syntax, data type, array name. Size and square bracket. This is the syntax. Data type means integer, character or float. Array name, name of the variable. When we use this square bracket with array, with variable name, that means we tell the compiler that we are dealing with array. Size, it must be known in advance. It is very important, repeating again, the size is compulsory. What does it mean? Example, if I write integer r 100, that means collection of 100. And type is integer. So I say the definition of the array is the collection of homogeneous. That means all are indexing start in 0. It is very important. In C, always array index start with 0. 0 to ... it will be up to 99. If I talk about this is n, then index from 0 to n minus 1. That means what we have? We have R0, one variable by default. Second is R1. Third one is R2 and .R99. We have 100 variables of the type of the integer. No need to declare 100 different variables. No need to remember the different variables, only one variable named R with size 100. This square bracket tells that we are dealing with array. So this is the collection of 100 integer variables. Second example, if I see, if I write one integer A 100, if I write float B 200, if I write character name 50, these are the example of array. 100 variables, 200 variables, and this is the one name with 50. Again repeating, the size is compulsory. If you write float B, it will not work. It will give an error. C says no. Size must be known. Second property. That means the first property, integer array is the collection of homogeneous. Second, when you declare an array, it occupies the contiguous memory location. If you write integer A 10, what do you mean by this? That means the first index is A0, second one will be A1, third one will be A2, ... last will be A9. And see the addressing. If I say the base address in memory is 100, then next A1 will be on 102. Can you tell me why 102, not 101? Because integer occupy 2 bytes space in memory. That means 100 and internally 101 for this. This means it will be entirely for A. Second variable, A1, 102, 104, it is A1. Next one, 1042, 106, it will be A6. So friends, on the basis of that, depend on the data type. We are taking integer, then the address will differ with 2 bytes. When I say character, ate 10, then in this case, yes, 10 bytes, 100, next will be 101, next will be 102, next will be 103, dot 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 dot. That means it is A0, it is A1, it is A2, and finally it is A9. Addressing 1 byte. Here 2 byte. But when we talk about float, it will be 4. That means it will depend on the data type you are using. So first important, homogeneous. Second is contiguous. Homogeneous data type, same data type. Contiguous means in memory, it occupies the contiguous memory location. It means if you know the base address of that, base address means the address of the first element, then easily you can retrieve the address of the second one, fourth one, third one, and up to the last one. So this is a very important characteristic. Anyone can ask, what do you mean by array? You will say array is the collection of homogeneous data type and it occupies the memory location contiguous. That means if you know the base, easily we can retrieve the address of the last element. Friends, this is the one introductory part, how array is used. First, we should be known, yes, what is the need? So, is it clear? So, need of the array? Need is this, collection. Now, how the data elements will be stored in array? Let's see the, with the one example, how data elements will be stored. Main. Integer A10. Integer I. What variable that use? For I equal to 0, I less than equal to 9, and I plus plus. Printf. Enter the value. Scanf. Percent D, comma, M percent AI. This for loop is used to write the value in an array. How it will work? Let's see. We have already discussed the concept of the for loop. For loop. Initialization I equal to 0. That means initial value of I variable is 0. So first it is the initialization. Second, we will check the condition. 0 less than equal to 9, condition is true. We will move into the loop. First statement that will print, enter the value. Enter the value, keyboard is ready to enter the value, scanner. The I is 0. It will become M percent A 0. That means the first value A 0, whatever you will enter from the keyboard, it will be stored in A 0 10. If you store the 10, that means in A 0 it will be stored. Again, I will be incremented. Now it will become 1. 1 less than equal to 9. Condition is true. Again, will be moved in the loop. Again, this statement will be print, enter the value, again we will enter, but now the value of I has been 1, so it will be M percent A 1. That means the next, or you can say the second value, will be stored in A 1. And what? Suddenly this is 20. Now third time, again I will be incremented, I will become 3, 2, check the condition, 2 less than equal to 9, condition is true, enter the value, and again it will become A 2. You will enter 50, it will be A 2. In the same manner, this loop will be executed and every time it will check the condition. But 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. When A 9, you will score 60. Ampersand A 9, you will score 60. And after that again I will be incremented. The value I is equal to 10. Check the condition. 10 less than equal to 9. Condition 2 is false? It's false. And you will be out from the loop. Now task is over. That means we have one array variable to store the 10 different integer variables, and using this for loop we are storing, we are writing the different 10 values of the same type integer, 10, 20, 50, dot dot any value, but indexing we start A0, A1, A2 and finally it is B9. This is the first task, to write the value. Second, continuous, how we will read whatever have been stored in the variable. Again, same kind of the same for loop we will use. How? Let's see. For I equal to 0, I less than equal to 9, I plus plus. Objective is to read. Read how? Printf percent %d and AI. We have already discussed when you store the value with the scanf, percent %d and percent %e, this address of operator is used to store the value with this variable. But the same kind of the statement used with printf without ampersand. That means now we are reading. Now let's check. Again I equal to 0. If the value I equal to 0, condition is true, AI. And what is the value of AI? IA0? It is 10. 10 will be printed. Next time again, I will be incremented. It will become 1. Check the condition. I less 1 less than equal to 9. Percent %d A1. And what is the value of A1? A1 is 20. So the value 20 will be printed. And same manner, every time the I will be incremented, and finally 10, 20, 30, 40, again last value is 60. So it is A0, it is A1, and it is A9. And it is used to read. This for loop is used to write, and this for loop in the same manner, but without scanf, yet we will use printf statement, and when we read the value from this variable A, here A is what? A is the name of the variable. With this index bracket, that means we are dealing with array, and here the size, that means 10 different integer values. According to the need of the problem statement, we will store the 10 different values in that array. Again, I am repeating again. First, we should be known what is the objective of an array. Objective of an array is we want to store the same kind of the value. We have a large collection. So again, it will be very tedious or complex task to remember the different variables name. Then in this case, we will prefer to use array name. Concept of array. Array means collection of homogeneous data type. Second, when you declare an array, store the value, it occupy the contiguous memory space. That means if you know the base address, you can easily access the value or address of all remaining, because you know the starting and you know the number. So definitely if you know the starting from 00, next will be 102 dot dot dot, easily we can retrieve all different 10 values from array. And this is the first operation, how will we store the values in array, and this for loop is used, how will we read the values from an array, and this is the one declaration. Point is clear, friends. This is the objective. Now on the basis of this array declaration, we have different operations from that array. Operation from that array, that means if we have to calculate, to print the table, to find yes friends, so last section we have discussed the concept of an array. It is one example of one dimensional array. Now, what do you mean by one dimensional array? If there is a one dimensional array, definitely there should be some two dimensional array, three dimensional array, or n dimensional array. My answer is yes. If array has one dimensional, definitely the array will be two dimensional, three dimensional, and four dimensional, or definitely n dimensional. Now let's see one example. This is one dimensional example array. If I say two, what will be my two dimensional? When I say there are five sections, section 1, section 2, section 3, section 4, and section 5. In section 1, we have 60 students. In section 2, we have 50 students. In section 3, we have 70. In section 4, we have 45. Or in section 5, we have 65 students. In previous case, what we are talking? We are talking to score the round number of 60, 100, 1000. But now scenario is changed. Scenario is, we have five different sections. How many sections? Five different sections. An individual section has its own capacity with 60, 50, 70, 45, and 65. But if you use the concept of the one-dimensional array to store the round number of D60, plus 50, plus 70, plus 45, plus 65. Yes, my answer is okay, you can do. But see, check the condition. In section 1, first we have roll number 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, roll number 60. And again in section 2, the roll number start with 1, 2, dot, 50. And again section 3, we start the roll number 1, 2, dot, 70. And the same scenario that we follow with the 4 and 5. That means in section 1 to 60, and again in section 2, 1 to 50. How you relate? The first is with this first, 1 with this second, 1 with this one. That means if we have roll number 1, how we can recognize this one is from section 3, this one is from section 2, and this one is from section 1. Clear? My objective is, again repeating, in previous case when we are talking about the one dimensional, again it is very tedious or complex task to remember the different kind of the variable and to store and to retrieve, then we introduce the concept of an array. In such scenario, that means we have only one section. Now scenario is changed. We have five different sections or different number of the section. Individual section is own capacity with the repetition values or maybe some different values. But how will we relate this one with this one, this one with this two, this one with this? In this case, we introduce the concept of the two-dimensional array. What is the meaning of the two-dimensional array? Let's see. If you see, integer A, how many sections we have? We have five sections. This is the first index. This is the represent number of rows. Second dimension, that means individual section, that is 60, 50, 70, 45, and 65. So maximum is 70. Out of these, what we have maximum value? 70. And do you remember, in previous lecture we have discussed, size must be known in advance. What is the meaning of our repeating again? Size B must mean, if you write integer A, this is invalid statement. When you write integer A, 20. It is valid statement. It means size is compulsory. So out of these 5 different sections, what is the maximum value? 60, 50, 70, 45, 65? The maximum value is 70. So the second dimensional of this array is 70. In array, what we do? This is the drawback, you can say. Always we take the maximum value. So two-dimensional array, 5 and 70. How it will be repeated mathematically? If you see, remember the concept of the matrix. Two-dimensional matrix, number of rows and number of columns. In this case, the first dimension row and second dimension represent the column. How it will be? It will be in this manner. First row, remember index NC, start with 0, 2, 4. This is the first, and this means 0 to 69. First row index 0, 0. I am talking about index, not the value. 0, 1, that means first section, first value, first section, first row number, first section, second row number, first section, third row number, and finally bottom. Now let's see, in second row, second section, because we start the index with n minus 1, so second means 1, 0 means first, 1, 1, 1, 2, dot. The same scenario, what we do? We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, that means finally that we have 3, 2, 0, total we have 69. 3, 2, 60. This is the two-dimensional array. So total number of element means this first row represent first section. This row represent second section. This row represent third, and this row represent the last section. And we are storing all values by using only one variable, A, but using the concept in place of the one-dimensional, two-dimensional. The first number of the section, second the maximum capacity of individual section. So in out of these 5, we have one section with the capacity of the 70, so we have to take 70. If you take less, or you can say 50. 50 is okay for the first section, 50 is for the second section. But what about when we talk about the third section with the capacity of 70? So we will take the maximum allocation. So maximum allocations. So this is the one mathematical model. How will we store the two-dimensional array? Two-dimensional array says the first is row 1, this is row 2, and this represent column. But we remember in C always index will start with 0. So this will be row 0, row 1, and row n minus 1. So we say the general statement of this integer name A rows, or you can say the column. So this is the scenario of the two-dimensional array. Thank you.